find the antiderivative of the tripled tangent of x, notice that what you're going to do, you're going to split the tangent tripled as tangent squared x times tan of x dx. And then you could express the first one as secant squared x minus 1, using the famous identity, right? Tan squared is equal to secant squared x minus 1 times tangent x dx. Right, so then you're going to distribute and you're going to have two different integrals. Secant squared of x tan of x dx minus tan of x, right? Minus tan of x dx. So here, this is straightforward. U is equal to tan of x. Du is precisely secant squared x dx, right? This times the secant squared, that's the du. Right, so you're going to have u du minus, and you can write the second integral as sine of x over the cosine of x dx. Right, so then you're going to get 1 half u squared minus. Now, you're going to use the u substitution. U is equal to cosine of x, of course. The rule of thumb is that when you see a fraction, choose the bottom as the u value, right? Because you can't have the bottom as the du, right? That's not possible, right? So choose this as the u, because the du should be on the top, right? So the du is going to be negative sine of x dx. Right, since there is no negative sign in the beginning, we have to compensate. Well, actually there is, right? We can apply this negative sign as part of the du. Right, so as a result, we can just set this as a plus, right? Because this minus is eaten up for the du, right? So, so as a result, what do we have? We have 1 over u du, right, plus constant. Right? Why constant? Because we already have one antiderivative solved for, which was 1 half u squared. Setting this in terms of the original variable, well, I used the u again, didn't I? But you know which u I was meaning, right? In this case, u is what? Well, you know what? Let's change it into a different variable, just in case. Who knows, maybe your professor will be angry if you use the u again. It's a different u each time, right? So in this case, let's use it as v, right, dv, and let's use this as v, right? So this should be dv as well. Let's change this as dv. dv. Okay, now it makes sense. So 1 half u squared. U was tangent, right? So 1 half tangent squared x. Perfect. And this will give you ln of v, right, plus ln of absolute value v. What is v? Cosine, right? Absolute value of cosine of x plus c. Right? Why does the constant change to c? Because we already have another antiderivative solved for, right? That's why it creates another constant. Another constant with the original constant may give you a different constant, right? So this is the final constant, right? So this is the correct antiderivative. If you got this, you were correct. Thanks so much for watching. Hope this was a lot of fun. See you in the next video.